I write a daily newsletter about social networks, and one of my readers wrote to me saying, I moderate content for Facebook in Phoenix, and I'd like to talk to you about it. And over the next 3 months, I was able to talk to 7 people who were doing this work. I've now talked to more than 15, and just really trying to understand their working conditions.
Why do you think that, first of all, who are the types of people we're talking about who work there?
Right, so this is a low-paying job. It pays about $15 an hour, so somebody who's going to be looking at this very violent imagery is going to be making about $28,000 a year, but that's 20% more than minimum wage in Arizona, and so folks, you know, in many cases are eager to do it.
Are these young people? What is the age breakdown?
So eventually I made it onto the floor itself. Facebook invited me in, and when I looked around, it sort of seemed like everyone was in their 20s and 30s. It almost had like kind of a, you know, college feel to it.
Why do you think they invited you in?
Well, after I told them what I'd found, I think they were eager to show me that the stories I heard were not the experiences of every single moderator. And so I was able to speak with some folks who said that they were having a better experience. They felt safe. They felt supported. But I have to tell you, since I published my story, I've been inundated from hearing from contractors around the world, not just at Facebook, who are experiencing very similar conditions.
So Jimmy Pethakoukas at AEI, I thought, summed it up well this week, because obviously everyone's been talking about what you found. They've been talking about the ways that employees were coping with this trauma at the workplace, beyond the workplace, maybe some therapy and counseling and all of that that might be needed. And Jimmy's point was, you know, Facebook gets in trouble when it doesn't moderate content and now when it does.
Yeah.
Is there any way other than going through these images one by one? I mean, we've had investors say they don't want to invest in Facebook this year because Mark Zuckerberg's effort to right the ship is by hiring thousands and thousands more. This is a huge amount of money they're going to be spending. What we're seeing is the tip of the iceberg of what is needed to really moderate the content out there.
Yeah.
What implications is that going to have?
Well, like everything you say is true. You know, it's also true that Facebook earned record profits last quarter, $6 billion. And I think they could easily pay these folks double, and it wouldn't really dip into Facebook's ability to grow in the future. So, you know, is it true that this is going to be expensive? Sure. But as I try to point out in the piece, this is essential work, right? We're not just talking about, you know, questions of violence. We're talking about, like, our speech on the internet, and think about how much of that takes place on Facebook. So this has to be a core priority for them so that we all feel comfortable using it.
I'm not sure what doubling the wage would even achieve. I mean, you could triple, you could quadruple, it could be $1 million a year job. And I don't know how people are supposed to deal with the trauma. I mean, explain some of the images without being too graphic, the kinds of things on a typical shift that people are looking at.
Sure. So, I mean, you're talking about drug cartel violence. It could be a beheading. It could be content from ISIS. People have described a drowning to me. And there's child exploitation content. So on one hand, you're right. Like, this is never going to be an easy job. But there are other people who do this, like in law enforcement, and they do get paid better. They have access to more resources. More money goes a long way. It's not a panacea, but I do think it's the right start.
What is Facebook going to do about this, knowing that they're trying to do this for the right reasons, meaning so that typical people on the platform don't see this kind of imagery, but it's exposing a whole new set of people to this trauma that they could then, I don't know, they could be sued for this in the long run.
Yeah, it's true. They are in a very tricky position. There is no easy answer to this problem, but, you know, the thing I always keep in mind is Facebook has worked very hard to grow this big. They've hired the smartest people in the world to make sure they get as big as they possibly can. This is just one more unintended consequence that comes along with that growth. So it's on them to fix it.
Casey, thank you so much for joining us. We'll continue to follow your work.